Thank you. Hello, everybody, and welcome to NKE Bing Conference. This segment, we're going to talk about sustainability. I am very excited to be talking about sustainability with our today's guest. Joining me from Autodesk is Jad Dalel. Jad, welcome to our Bing Conference.
Thank you so much, Fabio. I'm really excited to be here with my friend Fabio. I know you are also passionate about sustainability, so I'm looking forward to the conversation.
I am. And after our talk that we already had, I'm quite sure that sustainability is not just your job, isn't it?
You are right, Fabio. So a few years ago, I've been really passionate about digital transformation and BIM. And I was doing it for two reasons, because I saw the value in it. And I saw that it's somehow, it's specific to few people who are doing it. So I felt like the need to democratize in it. And it's the same thing for sustainability. For me, sustainability is a topic, is a language that everyone needs to learn, not only the experts. So sustainability should be really democratized, should be learned at schools. And that's why I even wrote a book. I have two books in Amazon, by the way. I didn't share this with you, Fabio. I have two books about sustainability for busy people, just to contribute to this thing. Like, I need to make sustainability approachable to everyone, not only a topic that is only discussed by experts.
So what do you do exactly in Autodesk?
So what I do at Autodesk, I'm working with customers and account teams trying to solve their sustainability challenges using technology. So I work with partners like yourself. I work with customers, different type of customers, larger and smaller, to solve their sustainability challenges, from reducing waste, reducing energy consumption, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay. In the next 10 minutes, I would like to approach sustainability with you from a different perspective. The perception I get when talking sustainability, or hearing about sustainability, or reading about sustainability, is that it seems to be mainly a marketing buzzword. But sustainability is much more than that. To me, it is an opportunity to achieve social and environmental goals while working on economically sustainable results. This is what is called triple line sustainability. And it is a way to measure performance, which is basically planet, people, and profit. Me personally, I work with data. NKE works with data. Every customer of ours works with data. We live in a data-driven world. BIM is an information model based on data, and Autodesk provides tool to visualize data. But could you please explain us how a profit-driven organization could actually measure their sustainability impact? And one more question I'm asking you to dive into, because this is what everybody is asking us. Can you please share some best practice with us, KPIs, projects, financials, numbers?
Fabio, these are really great questions, and it will be really hard to cover everything in 10 minutes. But I will try to do my best. So that's my thing. So, and you are completely right. Sustainability is more than a buzzword. So it's now, and I said that, it's a language. It should be a language. It's an opportunity. I'm discussing every day with CEOs, with customers, different levels, directors, managers. They see sustainability as a big opportunity. And I will share with you here the opportunity I'm seeing from the conversation I'm having with these companies. So, beyond the brand, beyond the mitigation of risk, there are opportunities of business. And that's why I really am passionate about this topic. And I would like to share with you a few ideas and few trends we are seeing from the conversation we are having with the customers. And I think I have few customer examples that I will be sharing with you. But please reach out to me if you have any questions. Reach out to Fabio. I will be more than happy to share with you more examples relevant to your industry. So the opportunity we are seeing here, you need to know that 74 countries have already put net zero commitment in place. which means now they are accountable. They need to reach this. They need to reach this net zero. They need to reduce their carbon emissions. And in addition to that, more than 3,000 companies already committed because they know this is the future. They know there is a risk there. They know there is an opportunity there. So the opportunity there is, as I said, these countries are trying to reach net zero. So what they will do to reduce this carbon emissions, they will implement regulations, and there are carbon taxes. So now most likely you heard about the carbon taxes. And by the way, I checked on Italy, the carbon tax price now is $15. It's 15 euros and 15 euros a ton of carbon emissions.
Can
and
you give us Spain as well? Sorry, since we are in Italy.
Spain is 16. It's between 16 and 18. I don't know here if you can see it on the slide.
Yeah, we see it.
It's better. Yeah. Right. So Spain is 16. I can see it here. It's 18. So it's not too far. But the thing is, the carbon prices are already there and they will grow over time. I shared this with you, Fabio, in our conversation before that in 2010, it was an average price of €5, $5. And since 2010 to today, the price is becoming 50. So imagine these prices and these carbon taxes will grow and grow, and this will reduce our opportunity to do more business. So we need to innovate. We need to find a way to avoid these taxes and put the money where we need to put it. So that's why my conversation with customers is really about circularity, is about reducing waste, reducing carbon emissions. And these are really the big trends we are seeing. Here, just on this in this curve, you can see here some recommendation. And by the way, this is coming from the World Bank reports. I will be sharing the slides with Fabio. We can get them later, and you will see the references. So it's a huge report where they are recommending the countries and even the companies to price the carbon between 40 and 80 to have an impact, which means for Italy, for France, for other countries who are below 40, they will come to 40 and they will need to go beyond 40 to reduce this. That means the taxes will grow and grow. So just this is an opportunity also for innovators to find a way how to avoid that for companies. And also I'm mentioning here the emission trading system, which means if you are a sustainable company, you can trade the permission to pollute with other companies, so they can buy this from you. So that's one opportunity. This is really quickly, I mean, this is just to have the conversation also going maybe later, is to reach the net zero, there are 9 requirements according to McKinsey. One of these requirements is technology and innovation. So that's why, and we are here, Fabio and I, we are here to support you with technology to achieve this sustainability goals. There are others, I will let you read this, but keep in mind that technology will play a big role here to achieve net zero, to achieve sustainable goals. We've been doing this year and the past years, I mean, Autodesk, we've been running some surveys across all our customers. And all our customers, you mentioned again, Fabio, sustainability is not it's beyond marketing, beyond buzz. It's not a buzzword. Now it's a priority. And we are seeing customers embedding this into their strategy. A lot of customers we are talking to, can see here the number, 69% of them are focusing on climate action, focusing on responsible consumption, focusing on clean energy and what have you. So, and on the left, maybe just for the attendees who are not familiar with these colors, the 17, they are called the 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. These are the blueprints to achieve a sustainable development. For me, it's a practical definition for sustainability. Sustainability is really working toward the 17 goals and trying to achieve them. You can be committed to all these goals, but in your business, you can focus on few where you can have an impact. So Yes, lots of companies now, they are trying to translate these goals, these 17 United Goals, to initiatives. And you can see around you, a lot of companies are working toward net zero initiatives, e-mobility, and many, many projects to achieve this. And I like this slide because this is a result from Harvard University, where they compared two sites, 90 companies who are embedding sustainability into their strategy and others who are not. And they've been following these companies around 18 years. They noticed that the ones who embedded sustainability into their strategy, they showed they outperformed other companies, and they are showing more than 46% increase in their stock market performance, more than 60% return on assets, 23% return on equity, and even 23% return on energy efficiency. And this is one of the slides I'm always using to justify and to show the value of sustainability. From the business perspective, again, these companies are using it as a strategic level, not for marketing purposes. They are really implementing solutions, initiatives into their companies, trying to reduce waste, trying to increase efficiencies, etc. So I will be sharing again this slide. You will have the references. It's Harvard University. This research is known in the industry. Now, I will try quickly walk you through the priorities for the both big industries, the AEC, architecture, engineering and construction, and design and manufacturing. I will not go through the detail, but feel free, please reach out to me if you need any support on this area. So top priorities from customers, from the industry, and from Autodesk perspective are three: total carbon, reducing carbon emissions, climate adaptation, adapting to the changes in the climate we are seeing now and we will be seeing in the future, and finally, circular economy, reaching the zero waste. So these are the main ones for the AEC. And for the D&M, we'll find three others somehow similar. First, material choice, picking the right material, sustainable material, working toward operational efficiency in factories, for instance. And again, circular economy and helping supply chain to become more responsible and more sustainable. Here I will go quickly just to be transparent with you and to share with you our sustainability strategy, our impact strategy. And you will see that the main thing is really about you guys, about our customers, about our partners. So we have three main initiatives. First, improving our own operations, which means our offices, our events, our carbon emissions, our energy we consume. We need to reduce this. Second, partner with customers like yourself to achieve sustainability goals. So we work with you, we partner with you to achieve your goals. And finally, advance the industries, work with the ecosystem, trying to influence the ecosystem to come up with solutions to help everyone achieve the sustainable goals. And these three initiatives will be focusing always on three main opportunities of impact. Energy and materials, this is like the most common topic. We are always talking about reducing energy consumption and reducing waste. But there are other pillars that are also very important, like health and resilience. Now, after the pandemic and during the pandemic, we are talking more and more about healthy building, healthy products, healthy spaces. So this is really a priority. In addition to resilience, adapting, as I said, to the changes we are seeing in the climate. And finally, work and prosperity and the future of work, how we can help and can help the companies, the ecosystem, the communities to become to be prepared for the future, to upskill them, to teach them with the new technology to become more productive and more innovative. So I will really skip this. I will share with you the slide. These are really the details of the strategy. The goal is not really, I know we don't like slides with lots of words here, But the main goal here is really to share with you the information. You can read it. For every area, we have priorities and we have the solution to help for every impact area. So I will just skip them here. So energy, material, health and resilience, and work and prosperity. And I would like now to talk about your important question, Fabio, about the success criteria and the KPIs. I think I will summarize it on this slide. So these are three examples I have. There are really more than that. So the first example is Microsoft. All of us, we know Microsoft. So they have a campus. They are building a campus, a new campus for Microsoft. And they have a bold strategy, sustainability strategy, where they need to reduce their carbon emissions. So they partnered with Skanska, which is a construction company, and Autodesk to figure out how we can do that, how we can reduce their carbon emission. So we work together, we use our collaboration tools in the construction world. I will mention the BIM 360, for instance, and other tools to reduce their carbon emissions. And we were able to reduce this carbon emissions by 30%, helping them achieve their sustainability goals. So this is one of the KPIs, Fabio, is really reducing carbon emissions. We'll see this over and over again. What is the percentage of reducing carbon emissions? Second one is NBBJ. It's an architecture company. They developed a new service because they saw the opportunity with sustainability, and they start, in addition to the design solutions they've been always doing, they created a sustainability service to help companies to reduce their energy consumption. And by using our energy analysis tools, they were able to reduce 70% of their energy consumption. And this is another KPI, really important to know this. And finally, FactoryOS, this is a company we are investing in. Autodesk is investing on this company because they are reinventing the way we construct building, affordable building. And they were able to accelerate the production, and they are now faster twice compared to the construction method, the traditional ones. And they were also able to reduce waste by 70%. And they are doing even more than that. You can read about them for the, more in details about the stories. I will be sharing the links. And now I hope I'm not really, I think I see like we are 18 minutes already, but
that's okay.
Again, this is my email. Reach out if you have any questions. And thank you again for this opportunity. Back to you.
Jed, it was fantastic. I'm sorry, it wasn't much time, but we did our best to give an overview of sustainability. So our message to everybody is that it's not just about the planet, it's about the people, it's about process, it's about profit. So it could be a win-win. You showed us some figures. It's interesting. The reduction of the carbon footprint of Microsoft was 30%. If the Italian taxes, carbon tax is 15 euros per ton, we could reduce it by 30%. We would pay €10 instead of 15 euros. So it could be interesting. So on this, I thank you. And I'm sure that we're going to speak soon. And I'm sure that we're going to have a lot of questions. And I'm sure that everybody will start understanding that sustainability is not just a marketing buzzword, but is much more than that. It's an opportunity. Absolutely. Thank you very much, Jed. I'll speak to you soon.
Thank you, Fabio. Thank you so much. Ciao. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.